Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today on Need for Knowledge, we go behind the scenes to see how black salt is made, as well as an insight into what makes this salt so different from regular cooking salt. Have you ever seen salt that isn't white? The concept of any kind of salt that isn't white sounds weird and mildly unnerving to most people. However, not every salt is white or edible. If you know anything about chemistry, you will agree that there are different kinds of salts, and not all of them are white. Regardless, most of these salts aren't even edible, unlike the black salt that we will be discussing in this video. Don't freak out just yet, it's about to get interesting. Black salt is known by many different names, including Kala Namak, Sulaimani Namak, Bit Noon, Bayer Noon, Bit Luna, Bit Leban, Kala Loon, Sanchal, Gumaloon, or Padaloon Kala Noon. However, it is popularly called Himalayan black salt because it is produced from the salt mines in the region surrounding the Himalayas and mainly used in the Indian subcontinent comprised of countries like India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Maldives, Sri Lanka, Nepal, and Bhutan. Regardless of where it comes from, black salt is believed to have strong medical importance and is an ingredient of some Ayurvedic medicines, which are usually beneficial for digestive system diseases. As previously stated, black salt has been used in the countries of the Indian subcontinent like India, Pakistan, and the like. However, this tradition goes back hundreds of years. In ancient times, black salt was harvested either from the volcanic mines located in northern India and Pakistan, or the salt lakes that surround Sambar or Didwana in Rajasthan, northern India. And contrary to what you might be thinking, thanks to the name, the Himalayan black salt isn't really black when in powder form. However, it is relatively black when in large solid pieces. Black salt is a kiln-fired rock salt with a sulfurous pungent smell, as well as a complex compound packed with a wide variety of minerals. Just like other salts, it is primarily composed of sodium chloride, regular cooking salt, and different impurities and trace amounts, such as hydrogen sulfide, sodium sulfate, sodium bisulfate, sodium sulfide, sodium bisulfite, and iron sulfide. Each of these components has importance, which will be discussed later in the video. However, the most troublesome one would be hydrogen sulfide, which is toxic in high concentrations. Luckily, black salt only has it in very small quantities that won't significantly affect your health, so it is safe to consume. The big question is, how is this black salt made? And the production process begins with acquiring the raw materials. The raw material for producing the Himalayan black salt was originally obtained from natural halite, the mineral and natural form of sodium chloride, harvested from mines in northern India in specific locations of the Himalayas, as well as salt harvested from the North Indian salt lakes of Sambar or Didwana in Rajasthan, northern India. Traditionally, black salt was transformed from its fairly colorless raw natural forms into the dark-colored commercially sold Himalayan black salt thanks to a reductive chemical process that changes some of the naturally occurring sodium sulfate of the raw impure salt into pungent hydrogen sulfide and sodium sulfide. All the chemistry jargon might sound a little bit too difficult to understand, but the process is pretty straightforward. It involves firing the raw impure salts in a furnace or kiln for around 24 hours, while it is sealed in a ceramic jar with charcoal. Small quantities of babel bark, harad seeds, bahara, amla, or natron are also added to the ceramic jar. Once the fired salt melts, the reductive chemical reactions take place, and the black salt is then cooled, stored, and aged before it is sold to customers. The Himalayan black salt is prepared using this production process in northern India, with production concentrated in Hisar District, Haryana, one of the northern states. Although the Himalayan black salt may have been chemically manufactured from impure deposits of sodium chloride with the necessary chemicals, that is, small quantities of ferric sulfate, and sodium bisulfate, and charcoal in a furnace or kiln in the olden days. It is now commonly manufactured by simply adding the needed chemicals to pure salt or sodium chloride before firing in a furnace or kiln. Apparently, there is also a possibility of creating similar products through reductive heat treatment of sodium chloride, 5 to 10% of sodium carbonate, sodium sulfate, and some sugar. From what has been said, you can understand how relatively straightforward the production process of the Himalayan black salt is. And even with all the chemistry jargon intertwined with it, it is still pretty simple. This explains how the process has lived on for so many years. And with the specific location of the ingredients, it also makes sense why it was originally secluded to one part of the world. However, it is easier to get Himalayan black salt in any part of the country, thanks to global trade and development. This brings us to the next likely question on your mind: how useful is this Himalayan black salt? The simplest answer would be, very useful. However, it goes further than that. Black salt is extensively used in South Asian cuisines in places like India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, and Nepal as a condiment. Or it's added to chaats, chutneys, raitas, fruit, salads, and many other interesting snacks. A South Asian spice blend called chaat masala is dependent on black salt for its distinctive sulfurous egg-like aroma. And black salt is often used sparingly as a topping for snacks or fruits in North India and Pakistan. There are also a host of refreshing beverages like jaljeera, ampanna, and nimbu pani, which make use of black salt, as well as many other Indian summer drinks. Black salt is also sometimes applied to tofu and vegan egg recipes, and is an important part of Ayurveda medicine to treat flatulence, heartburn, used as a laxative, and digestive aid. It is used in jamu to cure goiter, treat hysteria, and make toothpaste by combining it with other mineral and plant ingredients. However, its use for goiter and hysteria is not confirmed and is only proven by word of mouth. As previously mentioned in this video, certain things make the Himalayan black salt quite different from your regular salt, and one of those things is the components. These components include sodium chloride, hydrogen sulfide, sodium sulfate, sodium bisulfate, sodium sulfide, sodium bisulfite, and iron sulfide, and each one has its purpose. Sodium chloride provides the black salt with its salty taste, iron sulfide gives it its dark violet hue, and all the sulfur compounds give the black salt its slight savory taste, as well as a very distinctive smell, and hydrogen sulfide is the most prominent contributor to the pungent smell. Also, the acidic bisulfates, or bisulfites, contribute to the mildly sour taste of black salt. However, you shouldn't let these unique flavors deter you. While black salt may have a funny smell, the smell dissipates rapidly once in food. Also, what it lacks in smell, it definitely makes up for in taste, as it is bold and distinct on the palate. Have you ever tried black salt? Leave your answer in the comments section below. Thank you for watching this episode of Need for Knowledge, and we will see you in the next one. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for new videos.